Today we are explaining you the block diagram of laptop motherboard. Laptop motherboard, how its function. So we will understand you the block diagram of laptop motherboard. These are all other connected CPU, north bridge, south bridge. CPU to north bridge to south bridge, and south bridge to IO controller, that is the LPC, least pin count IC. These three are the main ICs which are internally connected with the data bus, control bus and address bus. These three signals are connected each other. This is a main central processing unit which has a power supply by the VRM. VRM supply the 1.36 watt to CPU, and CPU will give the signals VID to VRM that what is the voltage required for the CPU. So this is a CPU section. And CPU has a thermal sensor which controls the fan. If there is an overheating of the CPU, fan automatically start. So this is a thermal sensor with the help of CPU it is connected. And after the CPU, it is connected. CPU is connected with the north bridge. North bridge is connected with the RAM and display section and RAM section. North bridge is connected with the DDRM, and DDRM requires 2.5 watt or 3 watt power supply, and this power supply generated with the help of this power supply chips. Primary power 5 watt 3 watt, secondary voltage 2.5 1.5, CPU core voltage 1.356, system power and battery charger and discharging section. These are the power sections which give the power to different chips. So this is a north bridge. North bridge is connected with the RAM, DDR, and another is the LCD and CRT panels. CRT required 5 watt, 3.3 watt LCD. And these are also connected with the MCH, also required 3.3, 1.05, 1.8 and 2.5 watt. And this is connected with the north bridge. Okay, then after the north bridge, the south bridge is connected, and south bridge has a connected with the USB port, IDE, CD-ROM, LAN, audio, mini PCI, Kai bus controller, and all other activities are connected with the south bridge. Mainly south bridge is a second, and the north bridge it is connected to south bridge, and south bridge has a connections with the help of this LAN, sound, mini PCI, card bus, and these all are connected with the ICH. After ICH there is an LPC, IO controller chips. IO controller require 3.3 watt and different power also, and south bridge has a 1.5, 1.5, 3.3 and different voltage, 5 watt, 3.3 watt, these are the voltage connected with the south bridge. And south bridge also have a different crystals, 32768. After south bridge there is an IO controller. IO controller also have the 32768 crystals differently. This IO is connected with the power chip also. In HP and other model, IO is connected with the power chips. These power chips in IPM, IO and power chips are the different chips. So these are the IO with the power chips, and this IO is connected with the flash, keyboard controller, touchpad and pen. And these power chips are controlling these power ICs. Primary power, secondary power, CPU core, system power, battery charger and discharging section. These all are controlled with the help of these IO power chips. And in some motherboard, after the north bridge to LCD, there is a graphic chips. There is NVIDIA, ATI, these are the graphic chips is connected with the north bridge between LCD and north bridge. And this is connected as a 1.2, 1.8 watt, 1.1, 3.3 and 2.5 watt voltage connected to the graphic chips. So these are the block diagram. Okay, every IC is required a different power, and it's also required a clock generator chips. Clock generator supply the crystals, pulse, frequencies to each IC. In different ICs, the clock generator supplies the frequencies. So we require the power, we require the data bus, control bus and address bus, and another we require the clock generator. After everything is okay, clock generator, then we require the BIOS. And BIOS come with the help of flash IC. This is explaining the block diagram of laptop motherboard. Okay, this is the basic modules how the motherboard work. You understand each section. These are all the buses are there, address bus, data bus, control bus. These are connected with each chip. It is a rough drawing. So just basic concept clearing, we have given this explanation.
Thank you, that was so much.
Okay, thank you. This is the first section of the block diagram of laptop motherboards.